everyone, welcome to Lectures by Aparna. This is the part 1 video of logic gates and logical operations. Logic gates are the basic digital electronic circuits that are used for implementing simple logical operations like OR operation, AND operation, NOT operation, etc. etc. They have one or more inputs and single output. These are the building blocks of any digital system. How does a logic gate look like? Logic gates actually come in ICs like this. In each IC, there will be many logic gates. These are the symbolic representations of each logic gate. Each logic gate performs different logical operation. This is OR gate, this is AND gate, NOT gate, NAND gate, NOR gate, XOR gate and XNOR gate. These are just symbols for logic gates. Each logic gate will be having an electronic circuit that is designed using transistors. For example, this is a NAND gate that is realized using PMOS and NMOS transistors. But we use logic gate symbols for making the study easier. Logic gates can be classified into three categories. Basic gates, which are AND gate, OR gate and NOT gate. Universal gates, which are NAND gate and NOR gate. And special gates, which are XOR gate and XNOR gate. First, let us see AND gate. This is the symbol of AND gate. It has two inputs and one output, which is a logical AND of those two inputs. AND operation is represented by a dot. So it can be written as Y is equal to A dot B. The AND logical operation can be explained using a simple circuit using switches. Suppose you have a circuit like this. Here there are two switches, switch 1 and switch 2. Switch 1 is represented as SW1 and switch 2 is represented as SW2. Then there is one lamp and a battery. Here two switches are connected in series. Now we are considering these two switches as the two binary values that are inputs to the AND gate. Let switch 1 represent input A and switch 2 represent input B. Now we will write a truth table for this AND operation. A and B are two inputs and Y is the output. When switch is on, we take it as a logic 1. When it is off, we take it as a logic 0. The lamp can be considered as the binary output of the AND operation, which is Y. So when the lamp is lit, we take it as a logic 1 and when the lamp is off, we take it as a logic 0. First, let us consider the case when A is equal to 0 and B is equal to 0. This means that switch 1 is off and switch 2 is also off. This is the off position. When two switches are off, it means that there is no connection between the lamp and the battery. So there is no power that is coming to the lamp from the battery. So the lamp will be off. It means a logic 0 at the output. So Y will be equal to 0. Now consider the case when A is equal to 0 and B is equal to 1. This means that switch 1 is off and switch 2 is on. So the circuit will be like this. Switch 2 is on means it will be in closed position. But still there is no connection to the battery as the switch 1 is off. And so the lamp will be off and output will be logic 0. That means Y will be equal to 0. Now consider the case when A is equal to 1 and B is equal to 0. This means switch 1 is on and switch 2 is off. So the circuit will be like this. Here also the lamp will not be connected to the battery since switch 2 is off. So the lamp will be off, which means logic 0 at the output. Therefore Y will be equal to 0. Now consider the last case, that is A is equal to 1 and B is equal to 1. Here both switch 1 and switch 2 will be on. So this is on position. It means lamp is now connected to the battery through this path. So lamp will be lit and so output will become logic 1. That is Y will become 1. So for AND operation, you will get an output logic 1 only if both the inputs are logic 1. That is if A and B become 1. And hence the name AND gate. So this is AND gate. We will continue the logic gates in the part 2 video. If this video has helped you, please do subscribe to my channel. Also, don't forget to like and share this video. Thank you.